Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, students. Last lecture we were talking about brand hierarchy and what strategies we would should be evolved in order to get the maximum out of our brand equity. And we were talking about brand hierarchy, as far as I remember. Let's take this discussion further and see how we can make better brand for our consumers. So I was talking about Toyota in my last lecture when we ended. So over here we have Toyota Corporation, we have Toyota trucks, we have Toyota SUV vans, Toyota cars, financial services, and then we have Lexus. Under the car, if you see, this hierarchy is Corolla, where internationally it has three different models. Camry, it has three different models. Avalon, it has three different models. Celica, which is a sports model. Then we have Echo, which is a boot version of Yaris or Vitz as we know it over here. Then we have Matrix, which is sort of in between Passo and Vitz. This is available in US, not here in Pakistan or South Asia. Then we have MR2 Spider, which is also a sports version, and it's a two-seater. Then we have Prius, the hybrid. So you can very well imagine and see how they have evolved their hierarchy and how they are spreading out into different segments. Now this is only the cars that you have. You also have SUV vans, you also have trucks. So all in all, these three make or are catering to 64 different segments in the market around the world. Now having said that, it's not easy to understand that what every segment needs. So that this means that it has to have a carefully planned out strategy for it to be implemented, for it to be successful. If that would not have been the case, Toyota would not have been rated as number one automaker in the world. So you can very well imagine now that how much research would have gone into defining these 64 segments and getting on board everybody in terms of their needs and wants, and giving everybody a car. This is also true for Honda. Honda is not only giving or producing cars, it is also producing motorbikes. So people who cannot afford a car can afford a motorbike. And then they have ventured into making scooties, which is typically for a female, which is a smaller version or a petite version of a scooter, Vespa scooter that we have in our market. And then they have heavy bikes, which are into racing and stuff. So like people who fancy speed and excitement and thrill can opt for that as well. Recently Honda has also ventured into aeroplane making, and they have come up with a business jet, and very soon it will be able for it would be available for marketing and for sale in the market. Okay, now coming to brand hierarchy levels, we have corporate brands, we have family brands, individual brands, and modifier item. Now You have, corporate brand, which is General Motors. Family brand is Buick, which is one of their luxury cars. And individual brand is a Park Avenue, which is totally different from what, Buick is all about. But it is a Buick family, right? And, then modified item or model is Ultra. This can, you can change it to Procter and Gamble, and then you could, have a family brand of Pantene, and then you could have, what, Pantene shampoo or something, and then maybe you could have, a modifier, Pantene Ultra or something like that, which is, a little different. So you could, easily identify the hierarchy levels and see, which would complement which. Probably a corporate brand would complement the family brand, or the family brand is strong enough to complement, corporate brand, and the corporate brand does not lose its identity, because it is very much important that the corporate brand has its identity intact. Its image should be as such that people should remain faithful to that corporate brand. In the case of Enron, people lost, their trust in Enron. People lost their trust in Exxon Mobil after that Valdez spill, and how this the whole affair was handled. Because there was, environmentally they had created so much, damage that it's irreparable, and up till now, the repercussions are felt, or the ripples are felt everywhere around the world. Now, corporate brand equity is occurs when relevant constituents hold strong, favorable, and unique associations about the corporate brand in memory. Encompasses a much wider range of associations than a product brand. See, so constituents hold strong, favorable, and unique associations about the corporate brand in memory. One, and encompasses a much wider range of associations than a product brand. Because the than a product brand means that the product brand is only for a small need, but the corporate brand might be, operating in different areas. Like GE, they have they are building, airplane engines. They are building hospital equipment. They have financial services. They have telecom services. So they have multiple, operations. So GE is like, stands out in whatever they are doing, and it is their belief. They are not bothered as to, what their individual brand is doing. They are not bothered as to what their individual brand is doing, but they want their individual brand to perform in such a way that it should add value to the corporate brand. And this is what, what they believe in, that they should be either number one or number two in whatever category they operate in. This is their, one of the missions statements that, they have, to be number one or number two in whatever category they operate in. They do not want to drop down to number three. They want to be on the top. So family brands are brands applied across a range of product categories, an efficient means to link common association to multiple but distinct products. So like, family brands, you could see Dove as one of the family brands. It was, just a soap at first, and now, it has a range of products from, shampoos to skincare creams and stuff. So like, it is getting into that cosmetic category, and establishing itself as one of the, premier brands that, women should, try out and, have faith in. And they are doing considerably well in that respect. Then you have, you know, individual brands restricted to essentially one product category. There may be multiple product types offered on the basis of different models, packages, sizes, flavors, etc. So this one product or individual brand is like, you know, they have, you know, different models or packages, but, you know, they do not have any sort of an extension with them. So if you look at what? Gourmet Bakery? No. Rahat Bakery. It's one of the brands, you know, which could have, you know, a smaller version or a larger version, but, you know, it has, you know, the same assortment everywhere. So there are many different products offered there, but the bakery as such has the same assortment in every place it is operating in. Individual brands could be, you know, KFC. Individual brands could be McDonald's, because they have, you know, other partner brands who supply different products to them. But individually, you know, it is just one brand which has, you know, a set of menu which is offered all across the world, though they have, you know, different menu options in different regions of the world, so as to make it more relevant to that area in which they are operating. You see, individual brands could be regional as well. They could be, you know, global, but most of the times individual brands are servicing a small segment of the market. You have to understand that, you know, that if sometimes it's such that, you know, people do not venture into, you know, other areas because they feel threatened, or they are not confident enough that if that brand goes into other areas, that brand would do, you know, any better than what it is doing right now. So if they do not, you know, see a future for their brand in different areas, they would not venture into that area. I would like to add here is that maybe you could, you know, see like if the fashion brands that are here in Pakistan, they have, you know, they are either catering to men or they are catering to women, and or both, but mostly, you know, the ones which are, you know, dealing in the formal wear are mostly dealing in formal wear, and those who are in informal side, they are not venturing into the formal side. So, you know, because they do not want to lose their individuality or their, you know, distinctiveness or their points of difference to the rest of the community or the brands which are servicing in the same category. People tend to have, you know, tendency of swaying to the competition when they see that their brand is losing its interest in the category it was operating in. It is like if you have a specialty and you're, you know, in a service industry or a food industry, you would not venture into, you know, something which would, you know, be against the taste of your current target market. You might want to, you know, have a sampling done before you could, you know, make a decision as to, you know, venture into other areas. Now, modifiers are the signal refinements or differences in the brand related to factors such as quality levels, attributes, functions. It plays an important organizing role in communicating how different products within a category that share the same brand name are. So, if you see you know, modifiers in terms of, okay, we could take the example of cars that, you know, we have, you know, for Corolla we have XLI, then we have GLI, and then you know, Altis, and we have Cruisetronic, and all of these are modifiers for the Corolla version of the car. All of these are modifiers for the Corolla car. And speaking of these modifiers, you would find these modifiers in cosmetic industry too. You know, like, you know, you have simple mascara, then you have a 12-hour mascara, you have a waterproof mascara, you have a, you know, a 24-hour mascara, you have stay on lipsticks, and you have, you know, simple lipsticks, and then you have, you know, gloss lipsticks. So these are all modifiers. The lipsticks is the same, or the mascara is the same, but you know, you have these modifiers attached to these mascaras, like your 12-hour, 24-hour, ultra, waterproof. So they are telling you, you know, the different attributes or the refinements that have been made in that product. And you need to, you know, identify these and make it more, you know, worthwhile for a customer to buy your product, because there are people who would, you know, who have this problem. I know a few females who have a, you know, difficult time keeping that lipstick on their lips, because whenever they are, you know, it seems like, if you know, while they are chatting, they eat it up. So they need, you know, that lipstick, you know, which would stay on for a longer period of time. It does not go off, you know, while they are chatting. So they would, you know, color stay, or, you know, they have, you know, Revlon has a special lipstick which stays on for quite a lot of time. Maybelline has the same lipstick available. Then L'Oreal, and they all, you know, have different segments to cater for. But you know, the ladies seems to have, you know, these problems. Then the mascara, waterproof mascara, came into existence because there was a need that whenever, you know, somebody used to wash their face or something, the mascara used to go off, and it used to leave marks on the faces of the ladies. So these modifiers, you know, tell them that, listen, if you have this problem, you should buy this product. You know, it has something extra for you to look into. Then while looking at, you know, the cars, you know, it, these XLI and GLI and, you know, Altis, they all tell you something that, you know, there has been a little modification done on the car which should suit you, should you, you know, want to buy it. Same is the case, like when Mercedes ventured into different segments, it had to, you know, identify that, you know, the luxury is there because it's a Mercedes, but it was, you know, the modifiers with like C class, S class, E class came into existence, so as to tell people as to, you know, what they should be looking at when they are buying these things, because these modifiers C, E, and S defined or said a lot about the brand they wanted to buy. Now, what corporate image dimensions are we looking at? You know, we are looking at product attributes and benefits. We are looking at quality and innovativeness, people and relationship, customer orientation, value and programs, concerns with the environment, social responsibility, corporate credibility, expertise, trustworthiness, and likability. Now, corporate product attributes and benefits or attitudes. That means what you want to look at is the quality and innovativeness. If you know, the quality is right, if people think that they are getting good value for their money, it is of quality. Is it something that, you know, which has certain unique attributes? It's certainly the innovativeness that they are talking about. Does it have, you know, the right people? Because if it does have the right sort of people, they would be looking after their customers and in return making, you know, relationships which are far more fruitful than any other thing. Because when a good relationship develops, it would be, you know, in terms of loyalty then, you know, there would be good word of mouth, and that good word of mouth would always in turn give them, you know, more business. So if you are looking after your customers well, then certainly you are, you know, in for a on the road to success. Then, you know, the customers are more worried as to, you know, what these corporations are up to, what programs are they doing, what social responsibility are they taking on, and what are they doing for the environment. So you would find, you know, Avon doing, you know, charitable program for breast cancers. You know, U2 doing concerts around the world to create awareness for certain environmental issues. McDonald's, after, you know, facing a very tough time within Europe, is now, you know, reducing the garbage and, you know, changing the packaging so that, you know, it makes more sense, it's more biodegradable, so that, you know, it does not damage the environment. Ariel in Pakistan is giving away, you know, a certain amount of rupees for every bag that you use and return to Ariel in order to get equipment for, you know, special children. So these values and programs, you know, really make a difference in changing the perception of the customers, and it certainly increases the corporate image of the organization. Many a times, like, you know, Procter & Gamble has ended up into, you know, a lot of trouble regarding its, you know, issues with the government and the Environmental Protection Agency, because they have been, you know, found guilty of eroding environment or destroying environment in the area around their research labs, because they have been testing cosmetics or chemicals on the animals. They have, you know, they have not treated their waste and, you know, put that, you know, those chemicals into the streams and, you know, in the areas adjacent to their factories. So at one point in time, their, you know, world famous brand Tide was named as Dyed because it had so many, you know, so much chemicals in it that, you know, it was killing all the microbes and healthy microbes which were, you know, required by the floral and fauna of the environment. But, you know, wherever, you know, that the water which had tied in it passed, it destroyed the living organisms in that particular area. So people, you know, talked about it a lot. You know, they were taken to court, they were fined, and, you know, then but apparently, since, you know, it's a big organization and a corporation, people couldn't really, you know, close it down, or it, because then, you know, they realized that they have to give something back to, you know, the society. And when they did that, you know, people went quiet. But they still feel that, you know, Procter & Gamble is not doing enough in order to protect the environment. Then your credibility comes into play. Corporate credibility is your expertise in whatever you are doing. Like GE, their expertise is, you know, in technological advancements in the field of medical science, in the field of engineering, in terms of, you know, making engines for airplanes, as well as, you know, rockets and, you know, satellites which go into the orbit. Then their trustworthiness again plays an important role. It's, you know, how the image has been portrayed to the people around the world, and through that they are able to understand what, you know, what credibility the corporation has. It depends very much on the team that is currently operating in the organization, and what measures do they take if any disaster, you know, takes place. As it happened, it is a very big, it was a very big news when there's a Johnson & Johnson, as you know, because most of us know Johnson & Johnson in terms of baby shampoo, a shampoo which does not, you know, originate tears if it goes into the eyes of someone who is using it. So it is tears safe in terms of for the babies. So we know Johnson & Johnson in that respect. Johnson & Johnson has product by the name of Tylenol. It's a pain relief tablet. It was tampered in one way or another in US, and quite a few people died taking that tablet. It was a capsule. Somebody tampered with those capsules, and it was only in a particular area that, you know, the people died. So they had to, you know, take back every batch, the whole batch, as well as, you know, other excess that was lying with the, you know, chemists or pharmacists. And they went ahead and they apologized to the world about what has happened, and they vowed that, you know, they would take care of everything, and they would, you know, compensate the people, though they could not compensate or bring back the people who have died, but they would like to, you know, do that. So in order to do that, you know, they placed a hefty price for somebody on the head of the person who had tampered with the medicine, and they asked the people to help them out in finding out who that person is. Then they, you know, made a huge investment in, you know, research and development to find out, you know, a way of packing those capsules in such a way that they cannot be tampered with. They replaced the capsules with tablets, so that people who are taking that capsule can, you know, alternatively take those tablets and, you know, make it work for them. In the end, you know, it was whatever was done, and, you know, they came back after 3 weeks with, you know, with a new version, with the packing and everything. And they said that they were sorry, and, you know, they came back and they wanted, asked for people's help to, you know, so that, you know, nothing of this sort happens again. So that trustworthiness factor came back, because then people believed that, you know, Johnson & Johnson can really deliver. Then the likability factor is also there, that people have a certain, you know, liking towards, you know, different brands. And if you have a loyal customer base, you certainly have a likability factor with you. Now, there are different decisions that you need to see in the hierarchy. So one of the decisions that you need to take is how brand elements from different levels of hierarchy are combined, if at all, for any one particular product. So different levels of hierarchy are combined, if all, for. So how would you know brand elements from different levels? What could be, you know, what can be combined, or what, you know, what should be taken, what elements should be taken from the brand, different brands that, you know, that corporate does have. How any one brand element is linked, if at all, to multiple products. One element linked to, you know, multiple products, that you need to, you know, identify. It could be the name, it could be the logo, it could be the symbol. How any one brand element is linked, if at all, to multiple products. So it could be a name, it could be a symbol, it could be, you know, a logo, which could be, you know, linked to multiple products, or it could be none. So you in order to, you know, enhance that image, you need to have, you know, the desired brand awareness. If that awareness is not there, logon ko pata hi nahi hai ki aap kaun hai aur kis tarah ye kya karte hain aur aapki kya product hai jo market mein available hai, to aap jo bhi kar lijiye, it doesn't make a difference. There are products, there are people jo ki ab ad hi nahi kar rahe hote. Yahan pe jo hai कुछ जो ब्रांड्स हैं वो ऐसे हैं कि वो अपनी इंडिविजुअलिटी जो है उसको जो है वो लेके शो करते हैं. जिस तरह फिलाडेल्फिया क्रीम चीज क्राफ्ट फूड्स की एक प्राइम प्रोडक्ट है, प्राइम ब्रांड है क्राफ्ट फूड्स का, जो कि फिलाडेल्फिया क्रीम चीज के नाम से. ठीक है. सो वो जो है अगर आपको यही नहीं पता कि फिलाडेल्फिया क्रीम चीज़ है क्या या उसका टेस्ट क्या है, सो इट डज नॉट इवन मैटर कि वो जो है आप जो भी चीज़ ले रहे हैं उस पर अगर वो लिखा हुआ भी है तो आपके लिए बेकार है. लेकिन फॉर सम अगर वो फिलाडेल्फिया क्रीम चीज़ लिखा हुआ है, फिलाडेल्फिया क्रीम चीज़ सैंडविचेस या फिलाडेल्फिया क्रीम चीज़ क्रैकर्स, आप तो वो जो क्रीम चीज़ का जो टेस्ट है, इट वुड, यू नो, कम इनटू योर माइंड, इनटू योर माउथ, एंड यू नो, यू वुड, यू नो, इमीडिएटली गेस के व्हाट टू एक्सपेक्ट आउट ऑफ दिस प्रोडक्ट. ठीक है ना. अगर आपको जो है मार्स चॉकलेट कहा जाए, तो मार्स चॉकलेट जो है फौरन आपके जहन में जो है वो मार्स चॉकलेट का जो है एक इमेज आ जाएगा, एंड यू वुड एसोसिएट दैट प्रोडक्ट. वो जो है मार्स चॉकलेट की आइसक्रीम भी हो सकती है, मार्स चॉकलेट का शेक भी हो सकता है. इसी तरह ओरियोज़ का शेक, ओरियोज एंड क्रीम, कुकीज़ एंड क्रीम आइसक्रीम मिलती है, वो हो गया. सो लाइक वो जो है वो एक एलिमेंट जो है, यानी वो जो नाम है, इज़ डूइंग एवरी थिंग फॉर दैट ब्रांड. ठीक है ना. तो यहाँ पर आप उसको लेवरेज कर रहे हैं, उस नाम को. ठीक है. फिर प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सिंप्लिसिटी क्या है कि जी एम्प्लॉय एज फ्यू लेवल्स एज पॉसिबल. आप जितने लेवल्स कम रखेंगे बिटवीन योर कॉर्पोरेट एंड योर ब्रांड, उतना ही आसान हो जाएगा इसको मैनेज करना. और इट हैज़ टू हैव, यू नो, क्लैरिटी. जो रिलेशनशिप है सारे ब्रांड एलिमेंट्स की, इट हैज़ टू बी लॉजिकल एंड ट्रांसपेरेंट. पीपल कुड, यू नो, रियली रिलेट टू इट. अगर वो नहीं कर सकेंगे रिलेट उसके साथ, तो बड़ा मुश्किल हो जाता है. जिस तरह जस्ट टू कीप इट सिंपल एंड क्लियर, ट्योटा ने अपने आप को डिसोसिएट कर लिया जस्ट टू कीप इट सेल्फ यू नो सिंपल एंड क्लियर फॉर द सेक ऑफ क्लैरिटी ट्योटा ने अपने आप को डिसोसिएट कर लिया फ्रॉम इट्स लग्जरी ब्रांड लेक्सस बिकॉज ट्योटा न्यू दैट इफ यू नो दे एसोसिएट देयर नेम विद लेक्सस पीपल वुड नॉट बी एबल टू टेक दिस लग्जरी ब्रांड सीरियसली बिकॉज ट्योटा हैज नेवर बीन यू नो नोन एज अ लग्जरी ब्रांड ट्योटा कुछ भी कर ले वो जो है एक रिलायबल चीप मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन है फॉर अ मिडिल इनकम ग्रुप इसी तरह निसान को अपना जो आपको डिसोसिएट करना पड़ गया फ्रॉम द ब्रांड इन्फिनिटी तो इन्फिनिटी जो है और निसान का जो ब्रांड है वो एक लग्जरी ब्रांड है सो यू नो दीज टू वेंचर्ड इन टू दिस लग्जरी मार्केट टेकिंग ऑन योर ऑडी एंड बीएमडब्ल्यू एंड मर्सिडीज एंड यू नो लिंकन ब्यूएक मर्करी जैगुआर ये लग्जरी मार्केट रोल्स रॉयस ये इनको जो है चैलेंज करने के लिए मार्केट में आ गए एंड दे डिड प्रीटी वेल फॉर देमसेल्व्स दूसरा ये कि देर आर एलिमेंट्स विच यू नीड टू डिसोसिएट योर सेल्फ विद बिकॉज कई दफा जो है जो बैड वर्ड ऑफ माउथ है वो आपको लेके डूब जाता है जिस तरह ऑडी 5000 वॉज अ ब्यूटिफुल कार एंड इट वॉज नॉट हैंडल्ड प्रॉपरली कुछ ऐसा हुआ कि कुछ ऑडी 5000 जो थी कुछ एक्सीडेंट्स में इन्वॉल्व हो गई और उसमें जो है उन्होंने कसूरवार गाड़ी को ठहराया रादर देन यू नो ड्राइवर कि गाड़ी जो है ऑटोमेटिकली कुछ ज्यादा एक्सेलरेट हो जाती है विच गोज आउट ऑफ कंट्रोल नाउ ऑडी जो है वो को बहुत सेटबैक हुआ फ्रॉम लाइक यू नो 74,000 यूनिट्स दे वेंट डाउन टू 21,000 यूनिट्स इन सेल्स समथिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट एंड दे फाइनली डिसाइडेड दैट ऑडी 4000 वॉज which was you know sort of carrying on the same legacy of 5000 had to be dissociated with Audi 5000 so the 4000 version came and you know it dissociated with 5000 and then even then you know people were not convinced so they changed the whole line and came up with the name Quattro so as to you know make more sense to its consumers Now, levels of awareness and association. Here we have two principles. Principle of relevance and principle of differentiation. Relevance creates a global association that are relevant across as many individual items as possible. Now, here everything is to be, you know, come into contact and in connection and, you know, complement each other. Whereas in differentiation, It differentiates individual items and brands. So, create global associations that are relevant across as many individual items as possible. So, I'm not sure. Maybe, you know, you guys can tell me as to, you know, what could be, you know, the best source as to what principle of relevance would have in common. And, principle of differentiation okay differentiate individual items and brands now we need to create awareness and association and for this we have you know different principles like you know first one is principle of relevance meaning create global associations that are relevant across as many individual items as possible so if you look at Nike they have ventured not only into you know athletic shoes they have ventured into you know the uniforms they have ventured into you know the sporting kits for the athletes and it is not anymore you know the running shoes it's into squash into hockey into cricket into basketball so here you know their slogan just do it makes it relevant that, you know, while using Nike, you just need to do is perform, you know. So it is relevant that they want performance out of, you know, their customers. They want them to feel good. They want to, you know, have an attitude, a winning attitude. Then comes the principle of differentiation. Now you need, you may be, you know, having, you know, different brands under your umbrella. But you need to, you know, differentiate individual items and brands. You should not be able to, you know, they should not be able to be, you know, coming into each other's way. They should be, you know, separate. Like you have, you know, they should all be, you know, into different categories, I must say. So like if you were looking at, you know, Lever Brothers or Procter & Gamble, so you would see that, you know, they have different brands in different categories, serving different markets. So they are catering to the needs of different segments. You have Dove, you have Sunsilk, you have, you know, Huggies, you have Dalda, you have Walls, you have Vaseline. So these are all different products catering to needs of the different segments. So they are, you know, differentiating each other by certain attributes. Then you have principle of prominence, that the relative prominence of brand elements affect the perception of product distance and the type of image created for new products. Now here you need to see if, you know, your parent brand needs to be, you know, focused on that particular brand. Like Slice, Mango Slice, that is available in the market. You would only see, you know, a product of Pepsi Cola on one side. It is not, you know, coming into prominence. They leave Slice as, you know, the prominence in a prominent place, you know, so that everybody could read that. They do not want, you know, Pepsi to empower their brand. Same goes for Lay's. Lay's is also a Pepsi brand, but it is, you know, the Pepsi Cola International is your PepsiCo is, you know, printed at the back of the pack. The Lay's is in the front, so the brand itself is in front. The mother brand or the parent brand is at the back. Then principle of commonality is the more common elements shared by products are, the stronger the linkages. Here, you know, you use different words or phrases in order to, you know, make it more relevant to the consumers. Uski misal aise hi hai, jaise HP jo hai wo different computers or printers banata hai. तो प्रिंटर्स में जो है उनके अगर आप देखें तो एक लफ्ज़ जो है वो कॉमन है विच इज़ कॉल्ड यू नो जेट. सो इट्स लेज़र जेट, इट इज़ प्रिंट जेट, इट इज़ यू नो व्हाट, देयर आर टू थ्री अदर यू नो एक्सटेंशंस टू इट. सो एवरी नेम हैज़ जेट इन इट, सो दैट इज़ अ यू नो अ कॉमन फैक्टर. सो इफ़ यू सी दैट जेट रिटन एनीवेयर, यू कुड ऑलवेज रिलेट दैट इट मस्ट बी एन HP. जो बास्केटबॉल के शूज़ हैं नाइकी के, वो एयर जॉर्डन, एयर फ्लाइट, एयर मैक्स, इस तरह करके उनके बास्केटबॉल शूज़ हैं. सो द वर्ड एयर, यू नो, यू कुड ऑलवेज एसोसिएटेड विद नाइकी एंड यू वुड नो दैट इट इज़ वन ऑफ देयर बास्केटबॉल शूज. सो दैट इज़, यू नो, द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कॉमनैलिटी इन दोज एरियाज फॉर द ब्रांड्स. नाउ brand architecture guidelines say that you need to adopt a strong customer focus, you need to avoid over branding, you need to establish rules and conventions and be disciplined, you need to create broad, robust brand platforms. You need to selectively employ sub-brands as means of complementing and strengthening brands. Selectively extend brands to establish new brand equity and enhance existing brand equity. So, what does it say? That you need to adopt a strong customer focus. You need to avoid over-branding. You need to establish rules and conventions and be disciplined. Create broad, robust platforms. Selectively employ sub-brands as means of complementing and strengthening brands. अब इस आर्किटेक्चर का मतलब क्या है? इस आर्किटेक्चर का मतलब ये है कि आप जो हैं कुछ ऐसा ना कर बैठे कि जो ब्रांड का इमेज है वो टार्निश हो जाए, क्योंकि जब आप ब्रांड बना रहे होते हैं ना तो यू आर ओवर एम्बिशियस. ठीक है, यू टेंड टू डू थिंग्स इन सच अ वे दैट यू नो बिकॉज इट इज यू नो दैट मोमेंट व्हेन यू नो एवरीथिंग इज कमिंग टू यू एंड यू नो यू आर ऑल्सो ब्रेन स्टॉर्मिंग विद पीपल, न्यू आइडियाज आर कमिंग, सो यू वॉन्ट यू नो एवरीथिंग टू बी यू नो put into this one brand, which over a period of time is okay, but you know if you do it you know in the very first go, you tend to you know lose the essence of the brand. उसकी मिसाल मैं आपको इस तरह दे सकता हूं कि अगर आप जो है अपनी जिंदगी का पहला घर बना रहे होते हैं ना, तो उस पहले घर के लिए आपने बड़ी एफर्ट की होती है, तो यू वॉन्ट यू नो एवरीथिंग टू बी इन दैट यू नो होम ऑफ योर्स और हाउस ऑफ योर्स. ये कभी आप अपने वालदैन से, चचा से, दादा से, ताया से पूछिएगा जिन्होंने एक के बाद दूसरा घर बनाया हो. वो हैव यू नो मोर देन वन हाउस इज मेड आउट and then they are living in the you know second or the third house that they have. क्योंकि जो पहला घर होता है उसके अंदर वो सारे एक्सपेरिमेंट होते हैं जो कि नहीं होने चाहिए, तो उसके अंदर जब आप हर चीज जो है वो लेके आ जाते हैं, ठीक है ना, बिकॉज यू वॉन्ट द बेस्ट फॉर योर सेल्फ एंड योर फैमिली, तो उस घर का जो मजा है ना या उसका मिजाज वो टोटली डिफरेंट हो जाता है. वो घर घर नहीं रहता है, वो एक चिड़िया घर हो जाता है या वो एक पेस्ट्री की शक्ल ले लेता है कि जिसके ऊपर डिफरेंट कलर्स की जो है ना फ्रॉस्टिंग हुई हुई होती है. वो पेस्ट्री देखने में तो बड़ी अच्छी लगती है लेकिन खाने में जो है उसका टेस्ट वो इतना मजे का नहीं होता. सिमिलरली वो घर जो है वो देखने में तो बड़ा अच्छा लगेगा कि उसमें ये भी है, ये भी है, ये भी है, लेकिन जब उसका प्रैक्टिकल यूजेज की बात आएगी तो आपको समझ में आएगा कि यार ओहो यहां पे भी गलती हो गई, यहां पे भी गलती हो गई, ये तो हमें इस तरह कर लेना चाहिए था. लेकिन क्योंकि उस वक्त जो यू नो द हीट इज ऑन, यू टेंड टू यू नो ओवर डू थिंग्स. सो यहां पे जो है आपको जो है ये समझने की जरूरत है कि इस तरह जो है आपको ब्रांड के साथ भी यू नीड टू बी वेरी केयरफुल कि ब्रांड जो है वो किस तरीके से रिएक्ट करेगा इस सारे सिलसिले में. नाउ हैविंग सेड दैट, अब जो आपका कॉर्पोरेट ब्रांड कैंपेन है वो क्या कहता है, डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर पॉसिबल. अब जो कैंपेन है कुड यू नो रिवॉल्व अराउंड डिफरेंट थिंग्स. इसमें क्या कह रहा है कि पहले ये कि जी आप जो पहला हो सकता है कि यू वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट अवेयरनेस ऑफ द कंपनी एंड द नेचर ऑफ इट्स बिजनेस. उसका क्या बिजनेस है कंपनी का, उसके बारे में अवेयरनेस आप देना चाह रहे हैं. दूसरा यह है कि आप फेवरेबल यू नो परसेप्शन और एटीट्यूड बनाना चाह रहे हैं कस्टमर्स का टुवर्ड्स कंपनीज क्रेडिबिलिटी. आप लिंक करना चाह रहे हैं प्रोडक्ट्स स्पेसिफिक मार्केटिंग को टुवर्ड्स द ब्रांड. आप जो है फाइनेंशियल कम्युनिटी पे एक जो है ना पॉजिटिव इम्पैक्ट छोड़ना चाह रहे हैं. सो दैट कल को अगर आपको जरूरत पड़े या आप अपने शेयर्स जो हैं वो लॉन्च करें मार्केट में या पैसे जो हैं वो रेज करने हों किसी प्रोजेक्ट के लिए तो आपको प्रॉब्लम ना हो. ठीक है, आपको जो है अपने प्रेजेंट एम्प्लॉयज को मोटिवेट करना है ताकि वो जो है गुड वर्ड ऑफ माउथ लेके बाहर जाएं और लोगों को बताएं कि जी वो कितनी अच्छी कंपनी में काम करते हैं, तो अगला आदमी जो है ऑटोमेटिकली उसको वो एक मोटिवेट हो वो कि आके वो अप्लाई करे ताकि उसको भी जॉब मिले इस कंपनी में. इस तरह जो है यू इंडक्ट फ्रेश ब्लड यू नो विच इज़ ऑलरेडी मोटिवेटेड इन टू यू नो डूइंग वर्क फॉर यू. ठीक है, और फिर जो है आप चाह रहे हैं कि जी ओपिनियन पब्लिक ओपिनियन जो है उसको इन्फ्लुएंस करें आपके बारे में. सो लाइक आप इस किस्म की बहुत सारी चीज़ें करते हैं, जैसे अब ये पाकिस्तान टोबैको कंपनी है वो जो है वो फ्री जो है आपको सैपलिंग्स देती है ये मानसून रीजन मानसून जब आता है उससे पहले या स्प्रिंग सीजन में आपको वो पौधे फराहम करते हैं कि आप जाएं और उसको लगाएं ताकि जो है एनवायरनमेंट बेहतर हो. उससे क्या है कि जो एक नेगेटिव इमेज है उनका कि वो जो है वो तंबाकू को उगाते हैं या टोबैको को उगाते हैं, वो उसको जो है फिनिश करना चाह रहे हैं या डिमिनिश करना चाह रहे हैं ताकि एक पॉजिटिव फीडबैक जो है वो उनके लिए रहे. नाउ मैनी ऑफ दीज कंपनीज यूज यू नो कॉज मार्केटिंग टू बिल्ड ब्रांड इक्विटी, और ये जो कॉज मार्केटिंग है उसका मकसद ये है कि लोगों में अवेयरनेस पैदा करना और एक फेवरेबल जो है ना इम्पैक्ट छोड़ना, लोगों की जो राय है उसको इन्फ्लुएंस करना, जो मैं आपसे बात कर रहा था. और उसमें जो है क्या करते हैं कि वो एक कॉज डिफाइन करते हैं, कस्टमर्स को इंगेज करते हैं, और उससे क्या होता है कि रेवेन्यू प्रोवाइडिंग एक्सचेंज जो है टेक्स प्लेस दैट सेटिस्फाई ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल एंड इंडिविजुअल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. इसमें जो है दे कुड बी यू नो सर्विसिंग SOS विलेज, दे कुड बी यू नो गिविंग डोनेशंस टू शौकत खानम मेमोरियल हॉस्पिटल, ये दे कुड बी यू नो अरेंजिंग फंड रेजर फॉर ईदी होम्स, दे कुड बी यू नो अरेंजिंग कॉन्सर्ट्स और फैशन शोज टू सपोर्ट IDPs. सो दैट इज यू नो वन ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट यू कुड डू. दे कुड यू नो क्रिएट अवेयरनेस फॉर डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ कैंसर्स इन मैन एंड वुमेन, जिस तरह मैंने आपको थोड़े देर पहले ही बात की थी कि वो ब्रेस्ट कैंसर अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम है, एड्स अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम है, उसके लिए जो है डिफरेंट लोग काम कर रहे हैं और फाउंडेशंस बनी हुई हैं और वो ये कॉरपोरेशन जो है वो उनको फंड करती हैं. फिर इस कॉज मार्केटिंग से क्या होता है कि इट बिल्डिंग ब्रांड अवेयरनेस, इन्हेंसिंग ब्रांड इमेज, establishing brand credibility, evoking brand feeling, creating a sense of brand community, eliciting brand engagement. So like you know इटिंग जो awareness और image तो खैर वो बनेगा ही, लेकिन एक brand credibility जो है वो भी positively establish होती है. brand की तरफ जो है एक feeling जो है एक soft corner जो है वो customers के दिल में बन जाता है या दिमाग में बन जाता है, और वो जो है आप उस ब्रांड के साथ एक कम्युनिटी की फीलिंग होती है कि यू एवरीबडी इज़ यू नो लुकिंग आफ्टर यू और यू नो दैट कम्युनिटी दैट यू वर्किंग फॉर. तो एक कम्युनिटी की फीलिंग जो है वो बिल्ड हो जाती है कि यू एंड दैट ब्रांड इज़ यू नो वर्किंग फॉर द सेम कम्युनिटी, एंड देन यू नो एलिसिटिंग ब्रांड एंगेजमेंट के ब्रांड जो है इज़ टोटली फॉर दैट कॉज. फिर देर इज यू नो स्पेशल कॉज मार्केटिंग विच इज कॉल्ड ग्रीन मार्केटिंग विच इज यू नो कंसर्न विद द एनवायरमेंट एंड ऑल इट्स एनवायरमेंटल इशूज, और जो है देर आर पीपल हु आर नाउ यू नो ट्राइंग टू यू नो गेट रेड ऑफ दीज प्लास्टिक बैग्स एंड यू आर कमिंग बैक विद यू नो क्लॉथ बैग और यू नो पेपर बैग सो एज टू यू नो गेट रेड ऑफ दिस दिस मेनेंस दैट इज इन शेप ऑफ यू नो दीज प्लास्टिक बैग्स एंड विच इज कॉजिंग प्रॉब्लम फॉर environment. It is a big hazard and people don't know and they burn rubber and these you know plastic bags which in cause you know damages the ozone layer above the atmosphere of earth. So green marketing jo hai ye bahut zyada hai, aur jo hai agar isme dekha jaye to Greenpeace is a big NGO which plays an important role in you know trying to control these corporations. Unke jo वॉलंटियर्स हैं वो जगह जगह जाके उन कॉरपोरेशंस के आगे खड़े हो जाते हैं और उनके जहाज़ों को, उनके शिप्स को, उनके ट्रक्स को रोकते हैं ताकि वो जो हैज़र्डस मटेरियल है वो ऐसी जगह जाके डंप ना करें जिससे एनवायरनमेंट ख़राब हो। सो फिर क्राइसिस मार्केटिंग गाइडलाइंस क्या कहता है कि टू कीज टू इफेक्टिवली मैनेज अ क्राइसिस आर दैट फर्म्स रिस्पॉन्स शुड बी स्विफ्ट एंड इट शुड बी सिंसियर। कुछ भी हो जाए आपकी जो रिस्पॉन्स है वो मैटर करती है आपकी जो है क्रेडिबिलिटी के लिए, कि आपकी जो रिस्पॉन्स है वो स्विफ्ट होनी चाहिए और आपकी जो रिस्पॉन्स है वो सिंसियर होनी चाहिए। कुछ जैसे आज मैंने आपसे टाइलेनॉल की बात की है, उससे कुछ अर्से पहले जब मैंने पिछले कुछ लेक्चर्स पहले आपसे बात की थी कैडबरी के बारे में, कि कैडबरी में से कॉकरोच निकल आया था और उसके बाद जो है दे हैड टू यू नो कम अप विद यू नो स्विफ्टली दे हैड टू यू नो टर्न ऑफ ऑल देयर प्रोडक्शन, सारा जो है उनको प्लांट क्लीन करवाया उन्होंने। उसके बाद उन्होंने जो है उनके सीईओ ने आके माफ़ी मांगी, उनको सबको दिखाया कि ये जो है इतना साफ हमारा ये प्लांट है, यहाँ पे ऐसा हो नहीं सकता लेकिन हो गया है तो हम उसके लिए माजत खाए। और फिर जो है उन्होंने उसको सारा जो है प्रोडक्ट वापस बुला ली और फिर एक नई कैंपेन शुरू की अमिताभ बच्चन के साथ जो कि मीठा हो जाए, विच बिकेम अ हिट एंड यू नो कैडबरी जो है वो दोबारा से मार्केट में बिकना शुरू हो गई। आज के लिए इतना ही, इंशाल्लाह ताला अगले लेक्चर के साथ मैं दोबारा हाज़िर होऊंगा और इसी से रिलेटेड और भी बहुत सारे चीज़ें हैं जो अभी बाकी हैं जिन पे हमारी डिस्कशन होनी बहुत ज़रूरी है। अल्लाह हाफिज़।